Good morning, everyone. Myself Patel, ma'am from SGM College Karat. Today, I'm going to teach you OCM for Standard 11. As we have started with the chapter number 1, that is Introduction. That is Introduction of Commerce and Business. Okay, that all this chapter is related about the business only. Business, what profession, employment, then various types of thing related to profit, etc. Okay, the last topic which I have teach to you was the role of a profit in a business. Yes or no, you remember that how profit plays a very important role. Profit plays a very important role in the field of every business, that is said as a survival of the business. Okay, we are going to start the next topic, which is the last section of this chapter, is the classification of business activity. Okay, classification of business activity. Okay, we will see and we will divide this business now into two big parts. Okay, that we will see today into detail. A big diagram is there into your textbook, page number 8. In that I am going to teach you today, each one into detail we will see. As business activities are broadly classified into two big parts, that is industry and commerce. Okay, that means various types of the activities are done into the business, that is related to industry and that is related to commerce. So we will see now, as we have started with the diagram, that is business is broadly classified. That means classification of business activities are broadly classified into two big parts. The first is industry and the second one is commerce. Okay. Okay, one by one I'll teach to you. First I'll teach you this half part and then the one, because in the one lecture I cannot complete the whole diagram. So first half part I'll teach you and I'll go ahead also. Okay, so business, which is divided into two part, industry, commerce. Industry is further divided into three part. The first one is primary. The second one is, name itself says, secondary. And the third one is territory. Okay, industries are divided into primary, secondary, territory. Primary is further divided into three parts. First is agriculture. Second is extractive. Third is genetic. Then secondary is divided into two parts. The first is manufacturing. Second is construction. And territory industries are divided into three parts. The first is transport, banking. Hotel, tourism, and the fifth one is, we all like, that is entertainment. Okay, so business activities are broadly classified into two big part, industry, commerce. One by one we will see. First I'll teach you this part, then I'll teach you this part, because at a time in the one lecture I cannot complete all. Okay, let's start with a business which is first classified into industry. Now what is industry? You know very well, industry is such a one, in a common language I'll tell you, where raw materials are collected and converted into the finished product and then it comes to the market. That means where production is being done of various goods as well as the services. Industry implies the economic activity that are associated with the conversion of resources into goods that are ready for use. I now only I said you in common language, which I said that industry is such a one where raw materials are collected, converted into the finished product. Okay, this involves production and processing of goods, mining, breeding and rearing of animal. It may be anything. It may be related to production or it may be related to processing of good, like I'll tell you where milk, from milk you can make so many things, like you can make cheese also, paneer also, butter also, yes or no. So at a time production is also done and processing is also done. That means where all animals are going to gather, livestock of animals can be there, from that milk can be collected and that milk is processed. At a time, these all things can be related with the industry. The goods purchased may be the consumer or the capital goods. Normally, consumer goods are directly consumer, final consumer, where capital are being used by another industry for further production. It may use like this, like, look, I'll tell you one thing related to, like, take an example of cheese. Now, cheese, it is made. It is a processed, which is done from the milk and other extracts itself. Now, cheese is needed by so many other industries also for making some of the another products. Okay? So, consumer goods are those goods which can be consumed there directly. But capital goods are maybe processed or maybe used by some another industries. Okay? The term industry also means a group of firms producing similar or related goods. Example, sugar industry refers of all manufacturing units producing sugar from sugarcane. You all know very well, as we live into the western Maharashtra, so many sugar factories we have nearby us only in Karad, yes or no? So here many things you can know very well, that is what, that from sugarcane is produced. Okay, then from sugarcane, sugar is produced. Yes or no? Sugarcane you know very well. So from sugarcane, sugar is produced. Not only from sugarcane, sugar can be produced, jaggery and all, so many other things also can be produced. So similarly, electronic industry would include all form producing electronic goods. Now, I'll give you one example. In electronic goods, so many parts are there. Now, that part, it may be produced from another industry, and that industry are giving them. Okay, and on that basis it can be produced. Yes or no? So it also creates services like banking, hotel, insurance, tourism, etc. All are related to industries only. Industry doesn't come into the part where only production are there. No, production, processing, you are depending on other industry, or you are making the product for other industry, like this also it can be there. Industry always create form utility. Underline this line, very important it is. Industry create form utility. So it convert the raw material into usable finished product. You can use it. You can consume it like this. All this is possible with manpower, machine and large capital investment. Always remember, manpower. You need men, employees for working. You need a machine for working, and very, very important, which is the life cycle of the business, which is a large capital investment you always need. Industrial activities are conducted in factories, workshops, sheds, or even sometime at home. It all depends upon the size of the industry. Now, if the industries are very big, okay, at that time location of that industry would also been very big, employees will be more, capital will be more. So always, what is the size of the industry, either it's a small industry, medium or large? For large industry, large amount of capital, more machines, more manpower, location will be very big, like this. But for the small industry, it may be there, like some of the another, like cottage industries. You know, cottage industry, cottage industries are mostly home based. In home, so many women are, you know very well, who make pickles, papad and all in the home only, and they sell to other. Okay, that is also related with the small. So it depends upon what the size of the industry. Always understand, industry create form utility. All the raw material are converted into the finished usable products. Okay, so always various types of factories, workshop, shed, or even the common home, all various types of industries are there. Got it, everyone? That was the meaning of the industry. Okay, so meaning of the industry. Further, industries are divided into three big parts: primary, secondary, territory. Okay, and again I'll repeat: primary, secondary, territory. Primary is further divided into three, secondary further divided into two, territory divided into five. Let's see the first one, primary. The name itself says what? Primary industry is concerned directly with the nature. From the nature, so many things we get. Example, the natural resources, first of all, which we need at our utmost part. So it is nature-oriented industry. The name itself says what? It relates with the nature, and it's a nature industry-oriented. So the products of primary may be used as the input of secondary. So always remember, the products of primary can be used as the input of secondary. That means what? Primary industry are related with the nature, and with that it will relate to the input of this primary can be used by secondary. Like for example, like manufacturing, for construction, you need some so many material that may come from the nature and that can be produced also. Are you getting? So primary are those industry which is related with the nature. The name itself says it's a nature oriented industry. The products of primary may be the input for secondary. Further, primary is divided into three parts: agriculture, extractive and genetic industry. One by one we will see. First we will see agriculture. The name itself says it relates with what? It relates with farming, cultivation, farmers, etc. Agriculture industry include farming and cultivation of land. You know very well, farmers. Yes, everyone we know, well, like India is famous for agriculture, and we as especially in the state of Maharashtra, yes or no, most approximately here the main occupation of the people is related with the farming and the cultivation of land. The quality of product depend upon many factors like fertility of land, climatic conditions and rainfall. Very important is that. Three important thing is there, which is the base of from how the product can come. So you know very well, that's why depending upon to the fertility of land, soil, climatic conditions, our in a country like this India, we have divided, like this state is going to produce this state is going to produce. Why this is so? Because totally it depend upon to the climatic condition, the fertility of the land, as well as what rainfall, which is very important. So full approximately your agriculture, the name itself, industries are those industries which are related with the farming and the various types of cultivation of land. The quality of product always depend upon the fertility, rainfall, climatic condition, etc. Number one. Number two is extractive industries. Extractive industries draw out products from natural resources. Now how the products are going to be drawn? It may be related with soil, air and water. Generally the products in raw form and they are used by manufacturing and construction industries. Always remember, it relates with the raw material, it's related with the construction also. So over here, example they have given, extracting oils and minerals from underground. That means you are extracting, you are removing beneath from the earth. Extracting, name is what? Extractive, you are removing. Like coal, mines, are they? Well, how you tell me, coals and all are they out in the trees? No, you have to extract. We have to dig, you have to do mining like this. Okay, extracting oil and minerals from underground. Then fishing, foresting, etc. Always remember fishing. Fishing from where? On the earth you are going to get? No, below the sea and all, you are going to remove fish and all, fisheries are there. Then if I say about forestry, then it is relating to the forest one. Here you are not going to get anything. You are then extracting oil, minerals, chemicals, etc. Beneath, underground from the earth, you are going to remove. Okay, extractive industries relate with the mining. Mining also, you do know the mining. Okay, so like in the Gulf countries when you dig, now commonly in the Gulf countries when you dig, petroleum products are going to come. Why? Because their fertility, their climatic condition depends upon that. Okay, so extractive industries always relate with the drawing products from the natural resources like soil, air and water. Always it is there in the raw form and they are used by manufacturing and construction industries for producing always various types of finished product. Example they have given, extracting oil and minerals from underground, means below the earth, then fishing, forestry, etc. It may be used in crude form and may be sent to other industries for further processing. It may be done in this way that you can remove in the form and afterwards you can do what? You can remove and afterwards you can process like this. Extractive means you have to extract below from the earth, underground from the earth. Number three is genetic industries. Genetic industries relate with what? Genetic industries are engaged in reproduction and multiplication of plants and animals. Example they have given, sericulture, horticulture, animal husbandry. I'll give an example about the animal husbandry. Now in the form of animal husbandry, when I say first four animals are kept, from four it become to eight, then 12, like this the number reproduction are there. Are you getting? Reproduction, multiplication of animals and plants and all can be there. Yes or no, the best example is animal husbandry, okay? Horticulture, sericulture, then various types of plant nurses, nurseries are there. All you can take an example that is said as what? Genetic. Genetic means when reproduction is done, okay? Reproduction, multiplication are done. Obviously, that is going to be there. Got it, everyone? Yes or no? Okay, that was about the primary industry, which is divided into three: agriculture, extractive, genetic. Let's move ahead. The next is secondary industry. In the secondary industries depend totally upon primary industry. Now only I said you, in the primary part I said the input of primary will be used as to the secondary. So secondary fully depend upon the primary industries. They convert the raw material provided by primary into finished product. Now the raw material which is produced by primary are given to secondary and secondary converted. Yes or no? Then example is given, tomatoes provided by primary industry are used for making sauce and ketchup. Now tell me, tomatoes are produced by farmer in the on the various types of cultivation of land are done, and farmers produce what? Tomatoes. That is primary. But that tomatoes when come into the common industries and where ketchup, sauce and various types of ingredients are made from tomato, at that time you will say as secondary industry. Because tomato when it is produced it's primary, but when it is brought into the secondary and convert into the finished product, the best example you will say it's a what? Secondary industry. Got it, everyone? Then secondary is further divided into two: manufacturing and construction. Now manufacturing industries are transforming, all these industries are related or engaged in the raw material into finished product, converting, transforming, converting, etc. with the help of machine and manpower. Example, textiles, sugar, paper industries, etc. Now first I'll give you the example of sugar. Okay, where sugar cane is produced in the farm. That is primary industry. Yes or no? Example, see. When sugarcane is produced in a farm, it's a primary industry. But that sugarcane, when it is bought into the secondary, secondary totally depend on primary because the raw material will be given by primary to secondary and then secondary converted. So from that sugarcane, which is bought by primary and given to secondary, sugar is produced. Jaggery is produced. Yes or no? Sugar, jaggery is produced. The best example is this only. Manufacturing industry, well, like paper industry, sugar industry, textiles industry, etc. Manufacturing means where raw material are bought from primary industries and converted into the finished products. Are said as what? Secondary. Sorry, I said as manufacturing. Number two is construction industry. Construction industries are totally engaged in the construction of building, dam, bridges, road, metro, canals, etc. Yes or no? You know very well, flyovers are there, bridges are there, big NH on the national highways, big roads are there, express highways there, canal, metros, bridges, turnovers, all are related with construction because they do various types of construction. Okay, in case of other industry, goods can be produced at one place and sold at another place, but goods made and sold by these industry are at only one place. This is only industry which create immovable hell. Now this is, see, construction industries will relate with obviously construction, where construction of road, bridges, dam, canals, metros are going to be there. But it is said as an immovable wealth. Why? Because where it is produced, there only it is used. You cannot give to the another industries. Okay, so that's why it is said always the goods made and sold by these industry are at one place only. They cannot give to another and then itself, because on the spot they use it. Got it? Secondary industry divided into two parts. And the last one is territory industries. The name itself is what? See, primary is related with nature. Secondary is totally depending upon primary. Now think about territory. Territory industry supports services to primary and secondary. That means what? A support is given. Like a pillar gives support. Yes or no? Just like that, territory industries support primary industries as well as secondary industry in various form. Like service facilities are provided by these industry. It include transport, banking, which comes under traditional category, whereas in modern time, hotel industry, tourism, entertainment, all are included. That means whenever you are doing any form of these thing in a primary or you take example in a secondary, all this is related with the same one. In detail is not given that, then too I'll say you in short form. Territory industry always gives support to primary as well as the secondary industry. Territory industry, all these points are included, like transport, transportation facilities. Give an example, I'll give you raw material are produced by farmer, but that tomatoes you want to bring to another industry like secondary industry, you need what? You need transportation, correct or no? So transportation is needed to go from one place to another, to bring the goods from one place to another. You need various types of banking services when you are doing various type of a payment. Demand draft is there, check is there, RTGS, NEFT, transferring from one account to another account, various type of electronic banking services or traditional banking services are provided by bank. Bank plays a very, very important role. Then hotel is there when you go from one place to another, or you want to, every time you need various type of hotels where you are going to live. Then next is tourism. Now tourism plays a very, very important role. Now nearby us we have a Mahabaleshwar, well, yes or no, which is one of the biggest tourism park. Yes or no? So you go over there, you live in hotel. See, example, you first of all to go to Mahabaleshwar, we need first full territory industries. How I'll give you? When you want to go, you need transportation to go from one place to another. Then there you are going to live in the hotel. You need, you are going to use various type of your cards like credit card, debit cards, banking is there. Then tourism, you are going to have enjoyment, entertainment is going to be there here. Then you are going to go various type of field like macro industries are over there. You are going to visit over there as a form of a tourism. You are going to do enjoyment, entertainment, everything is there. Yes or no? So territory industries are those industries which give full support to primary as well as a secondary. From primary also, for extracting, generating agriculture, you need transportation, you need banking. Yes or no? For manufacturing, construction, transportation and banking is the utmost point. Okay, see, transportation banking is in the traditional part, but in modern times you need what? In modern, you need hotel industries, you need various types of tourisms. They are going to give you, tourism industry plays a very important role, and that give economic growth also to the country with the help of various type of hotel industry, tourism industry, and as well as entertainment industries are now also included. Understood everyone? Yes or no? In this way, the first half point I've teached you. As I said you, that business is divided into two part, industry and commerce, that is come over into it. Okay, so in this way, today I have completed the first half part. In the next lecture, I'm going to teach you commerce and how commerce is divided into two part, and then further of this. Got it everyone? Okay, so in this way, today lecture is completed. Thank you.